How do you explore an existing project inside Foundry? In this video, we're going to take a look at two often overlooked features, the project catalog and the data lineage tool, to see how they can make a complicated project within Foundry more intelligible. Along the way, we'll make sure that you know how to find the Foundry Reference Project and its resources on your Foundry instance. Let's get started. Doing any kind of work in Foundry involves creating resources, like code repositories, data sets, and applications, that live within a project. This setup is analogous to files within a directory folder system. Each resource has a type that corresponds to an application that creates and manages that type of resource. And the resource lives within folders inside a project, where each project is like a root directory. You can find all the projects you have access to in the project's landing page, and frequently accessed projects will populate the top bar. That's where I see the Foundry Training and Resources project, or I can just filter through the list and find it there. A normal use case, going end to end from integrating new data through to building applications, would typically span multiple projects to reflect the semantic and permissions boundaries for different segments of our work. We'll touch on this in upcoming videos about the Foundry security model and permissions primitives, and you can find a thorough treatment in the Anatomy of a Pipeline documentation in the code authoring docs. In our reference example, for simplicity of distribution, we have resources that would normally fall into separate top-level projects, all within a single project space. This exacerbates a common problem in hierarchical, directory-based approaches, which is how to actually find what's important. One approach in Foundry is the idea of a project catalog. Here, you and your team can surface key resources from anywhere in the project, as well as keep an overview of project health and performance. You can see I've already added in the datasets that back our ontology object types, as well as our two applications and the carbon workspace, all of the resources we toured in the first video. We can also use the data catalog to jump into the data lineage tool. Whereas the catalog emphasizes what we choose to mark as important for the project, the lineage tool reflects the source of truth about how data flows through our project from resource to resource. This is critical to understanding how any changes we make upstream might affect downstream dependencies. If you start from here, you'll end up with a graph of all the resources in our project, which in some situations is exactly what you want, but often can be pretty overwhelming. Rather than starting with everything and paring down, I like to start from one point and expand out. The flight data is right at the core of my applications and my data model, so let's start there. The first click gets us a preview, and the next loads the resource in the Lineage tool. Before expanding things out, let's just see what we can learn about this dataset. The right panel tells us all the dataset metadata, along with health checks and any manual tags or catalogs that the dataset is part of. In the column details, we get the names and types, plus quick stats on uniqueness and null percentage. You can also see which columns are new in this dataset compared to its inputs. At the bottom toolbar, we can preview rows and columns, see the full build history, and dive into any specific jobs, and get a preview of the code that produced this dataset. Once we have the full pipeline laid out, these are the tools that will let us go from the 10,000-foot view all the way down into the Spark details of a single executor stage in one place. Now let's expand things out. We can go step by step or just add all upstream dependencies. Things may be a bit messy at first, but we can use the layout tools and grid alignment to tidy things up. And if you're like me and pass time in meetings by making sure everything in reach lines up at perfect right angles, you can spend as much time as you'd like nudging things into the perfect shape. By default, our graph coloring is based on the resource type, and clicking in the legend selects the corresponding resources on the graph. Changing to other color schemes is an unexpectedly powerful approach to understanding your pipelines. Color schemes like build duration and row count reveal aspects of how your overall pipeline behaves.
Coloring instead by data health can reveal where issues might be popping up. And the permissions view lets you investigate visibility and data access across your project by simulating the permissions of another user. You can also add a custom coloring scheme to group resources together any way you imagine. Just select some resources, choose a color, and give it a name. I like to use this to create a semantic grouping to help other folks understand what's happening at different points across my pipeline. Once we have a color group applied, whether one of the many built-in colorings or our own custom layout, we can use the group by color feature to collapse our large graph to something even more manageable. And if we're putting this together to share, for instance, in a stand-up or engineering review, you can even toggle on the simple presentation mode option and save keyframes to make it easy to walk through different views of your pipeline. While you're at it, don't forget to turn on curved edges for what, in my opinion, is a much cleaner looking graph. Once your Lineage masterpiece is complete, make sure to save it as a resource itself and add it back to your project catalog. Now everyone can share a starting point for exploring the project, both the individual resources in the catalog and the flow of data in the Lineage view. There's a bunch more functionality packed into the Lineage tool that we haven't explored here. It's the place to set up and monitor your pipeline schedules and build history, and is often the central tool in tracking down bugs or performance issues across your project. Check out the Data Lineage product docs and also the pipeline management best practices, which are in the code repository's documentation, to learn more.
Our last video gave us the overview of the Foundry Reference Project. And now that we have the tools to explore the project on our own, we're ready for the next videos in this series, where we'll dive into the three primary project components: how to enrich, clean, and transform your data, how to build a flexible data model, and how to build operational applications on top of the data that you've prepared. Now, keep in mind that this series is just scratching the surface of Foundry engineering topics. Make sure to subscribe because we have many more videos planned about common questions and engineering patterns, and we hope we'll find them useful as you start your engineering journey on top of Foundry.